How to throw a perfect 1-2. Well, let me show you here. This is a 1-2 on the bag. I'm setting my range up with that jab. You always want to do that when you're working on a bag. And you're noticing that I'm doing a little step drag there when I do it. So in slow motion, we're stepping on that jab, turning those knuckles over, contracting through the obliques, firing the right hand as we drag that back foot. Same distance that we step. Generally, around laterally around the bag works a little bit better. Alright, so now we're going to be throwing continuous 1-2s for this workout. Super simple workout. All we're doing is continuous 1-2s on the bag, and then we're going to do one weight exercise. Notice that my hands come back to my face, not at the same time. So when one hand's going out, the other one's coming back. So this is what we call continuous 1-2s. Then after that, we're going to grab a dumbbell. I'm using a 20-pound here. You can use whatever you like. We're going to do a swing. You can use a kettlebell as well. We're swinging through, and we're going to be racking that weight up. We're going to drop down into a squat and then press overhead. So we're doing unilateral work. So you've got one weight. So obviously, in the next time I do this exercise, I will switch hands and so on. So every time we're going back and forth from boxing to weights. And we're going right back on the bag, continuous 1-2. So you can change your tempo up on here too. You can throw slow and harder. You can speed it up and go fast. Just focus on keeping your abs contracted. Keep that weight evenly distributed in your feet, hands back to your face, and turn your knuckles over at the end of every shot that you're throwing. First two knuckles are impacting that bag. So again, we're gonna go right back into that weight exercise. You can see I'm switching hands, and we're going again through just like a swing, like a kettlebell swing, and then we're gonna rack the weight up. We're going to squat down and then press overhead. Make sure your chest is out and your shoulders are back on this. When you come down into your squat, make sure you hinge your hips back. And that swing, especially hinge those hips back when you're swinging through. So that way you're not hurting your back. We're keeping a nice strong core here as we do these. All right, this is a little bonus for you guys. How to push someone back without getting hit. So we never want to come straight in. You can see I'm moving forward, but I'm moving my head as I'm moving forward. So if we slow it down, I'm coming in. Now I'm coming in for defense, but as I come out of it, I'm gonna step forward with my shots. Right hand, I'm stepping with the left hook, dragging on that right hand. Again, we're gonna come in bobbing underneath, step dragging in with those uppercuts. So we're putting offense and defense together. Never walk straight in. This is a good tip for you guys.